Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm here again with Dr. Kishan, and today we're going to be talking about hormonal acne. Mm. Mm.
So some women do talk about acne lesions coming onto their face around about the time of the period or just after, and that can be due to hormonal decline, quite a sharp hormonal decline, a little bit like the PMS situation. So we've got a rapid decline towards the end of the cycle in progesterone and estrogen, and then the whole thing starts again gradually, but acne can present just at the end, just before the period and after. And to soften that, and sometimes to treat the acne, we can use progesterone to help stabilize the skin, prevent those acne breakouts becoming quite so frequent.
So other methods of treating hormonal acne?
Yeah, so I mean, as with anything, there's so many different ways to treat acne. So we can go everything from topical to tablets, for example. So we've got things we can put on our skin like benzoyl peroxide, like salicylic acid, and then we can take things like antibiotics or even vitamin A derivatives like roaccutane or oral isotretinoin. And we can do all, there's so many different options to us. I just find that if we have someone who's got quite an obvious cyclical pattern to their acne, it's worth trialing small amounts of progesterone to see if that will balance out the hormone sufficiently so that they don't get the frequent recurrence of the acne.
So what would you say to those patients who have maybe been prescribed the oral contraceptive pill like Dinette or like Yasmin to try and control these acne associated with the cycle? I was taking Dinette for years.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely a recommended licensed pharmaceutical way of managing recurrent acne. And certainly it works, and there's good case reports, there's good evidence to show that it works. However, it's still a synthetic hormone. It's not something that I have a special interest in. You and me are both aware of how synthetic hormones are totally different in terms of how they interact with the human receptors in comparison to body identical hormones, and you're well aware of the side effects of these things.
Certainly weight gain.
Right.
Big issue.
And actually, some of these birth control pills that are recommended for acne control actually have the absolute opposite effect. Mm. Sometimes people will say to me, this is something I've been put on for acne, and they'll have a worsening of their symptoms.
Well, that actually happened to me later in life,
right,
when I tried it again, and I got
acne. What was it, Dinette?
Yeah, Dinette again. So it worked brilliantly when I was younger, and then as I got older, it didn't work.
So again, it might be that the cause is something different now. It might be that, you know, your hormonal balance isn't exactly there, or wasn't there. Now that you're on treatment, things are a lot better, I think.
Mm. Yeah, totally. Mm. And there can be some other causes as well of acne. So, for example, when I took the progesterone-only pill for a time.
Which is a synthetic progesterone.
Terrible.
Yeah.
Terrible.
What was
acne.
That? Norethisterone?
Do you know what? I actually can't remember. It was years ago. Okay. Years ago. But I've never had...
So some of the progesterone only pills, and by the way, that is a kind of a misnomer, so just to be nitpicking, progesterone only pills will be progestogens or progestins, which are basically a synthetic form of progesterone. So what that means is that they interact with the receptor completely differently to the body's natural progesterone. So the side effects you get from progestins or synthetic birth control pills or progesterone only pills are completely unique to the type of pill that you're given. Some of them have much more androgenic effects, so they can make even your body hair growth worse, they can make your scalp thinning hair symptoms worse, whereas there are other progesterone-only pills which are much gentler and don't have the same androgenic effects and actually reduce the occurrence of spots or even hirsutism as well.
Mm. It's shocking. I had to take roaccutane. Mm. It wouldn't go away.
So one pill to treat another problem from another pill, and it just goes on and on. And this is why I think if we can try to streamline and try to simplify treatments for our patients, that's so much the better.
What would you say to patients taking spironolactone?
The spironolactone is a very good treatment, which is basically it's a treatment that's used to treat blood pressure. But in women who are not looking to be fertile or to bear children, because it's a teratogen, it basically causes birth defects in children. It's a very good treatment to prevent excess body hair and it also prevents hair loss, and it also prevents acne. So it's effectively treating the skin, and it prevents the effects of excess testosterone on the skin and the hair. It's a blocker. It blocks at the skin cells.
Yeah.
So you know, one thing that's really interesting now is in a lot of the anti-aging conferences that we go, and a lot of the latest evidence is showing that health is really a feature of so many different things like sleep, nutrition, hormones, stress management, and then there's this huge component of the microbiome.
Mm.
So if the microbiome is in balance, so that's the 1 or 2 kilos of bacteria that's living in our intestines, if they're in good balance and in beneficial balance, a lot of the health problems that come through our doors tend to be mitigated.
Mm.
So if we've got a healthy microbiome, that means at the very least having a whole foods based diet and minimizing processed foods. So unprocessing your diet, you can achieve microbiome health. That can also prevent problems like skin issues, like acne, and even eczema as well.
Have you ever done one of those stool tests? Look at your bio.
I haven't, not yet.
Yeah.
But that's next on the list.
So I did one.
Mm.
Yeah.
Do tell.
Great. It wasn't great. It's just an aside. Yeah, it wasn't great. Kind of interesting.
So we need to work on your diet a bit.
Yeah, I've been popping those prebiotics, everything, like there's no tomorrow.
So the other evidence that is shown is that probiotics are basically like travellers or like tourists. So they're in your intestines for a short time and then they are gone.
Mm.
So your natural flora regrow. And apparently the things that influence your natural flora or your natural microbiome are much more prebiotics. So it's the foods that you eat, which should be rich in things that, for example, produce butyric acid and feed the cells of your intestine lining.
Just going back to this oral contraceptive pill thing, I feel like it's a shame, you know, that it has these negative effects on oneself, because you know, what are your alternatives? Maybe we should do a separate video about contraception.
That's a very philosophical conversation.
It's very, very philosophical.
And controversial.
Yeah.
But I think sometimes, you know, the ends justify the means, you know, sometimes we've got to exchange one risk for another. It's all about risk benefit analysis, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Weighing up what works for you. And this is the thing about health and medicine and whatever you want to call it. Every person's unique. You've got to really unpick and unpack what their unique situation is.
Yeah, totally. Okay, cool. All right, well, that's it for this week. I hope that you have enjoyed this series about hormones. Maybe we will do some again at some point.
So one thing to mention is that if you are interested in actually just finding out much more about, for example, specifically menopausal health and andropause, in our website we have a special link which will take you to a video series. So this isn't anything to do with me and Sarah. This is to do with an evidence base for testosterone replacement and estrogen and progesterone, and how it might benefit people going through these times of their lives.
Basically, it's some other dude's videos.
Basically, yeah. But he's very knowledgeable. He's a compounding pharmacist based in America who I've learned an awful lot from. So he's a recommended resource.
Cool. All right, guys, we'll see you later.
Bye.
Bye.